But have you, I don't know if you've noticed, have you noticed while you're in London, you don't live here anymore, do you?
No, I live in Ireland. But yeah. I do visit quite a lot.
Yes.
So I might know.
Yeah.
Ask me.
Well, all of you have been around London. You must have seen these, the Anthony Gormley bronze figures. Have you seen them?
They're all over.
They're all over the place. There they are. So it's these. And it's basically, it's a life-size statue of himself, which he's positioned around central London. So we were thinking, you see, because they're quite far, none of them that close to the studios. Mm. So we thought, wouldn't it be nice to have one outside the studio by the river? So there's our camera out on the South Bank, but where to find a naked bronze man at such short notice? Well... Do you remember, Alex? Now, there's a speaker under that bench with the man with the umbrella, so I can speak to him.
Oh, man.
Can you hear me, Alex?
Hi, Graham.
Well, you're not to move, Alex. That's your challenge, just stay still like a lovely bronze statue. All right.
Okay.
No, hush.
Let's watch some people going by. It's raining, so we'll have to wait a while. Oh.
Hello, pretty lady.
Imagine jogging in the rain. It looks so miserable.
Hey, jogging tits.
I might get one of these rigged up outside my house. Abuse people in the street. Central London. It is quite quiet, isn't it, Central London? Oh. Right, goodbye, Alex. Bye. Bless you.
Oh, man.
Well, after all that standing about, it's time for a song. So please welcome the soul diva from Devon. Ladies and gentlemen, it is Miss Joss Stone is here. How pretty. Hello. I'm very well. Sit yourself down.
Hello, darling.
Oh.
Hello. Hello there, you're
Harry.
Hilarious.
Oh, much. It's a little love fest there. Sit you down.
Hello.
Oh, how are you?
I'm okay.
Because now you did Glastonbury this weekend.
Yeah, it was fun. It was muddy, man.
But now, presumably, they keep you away from the muddiness.
Oh, no, I went out into it. It was my fault.
And is it really as muddy as people say?
Well, I was only there the first day, so, and it was ridiculous. It was like up here. So I don't know what it's like. When I left, I don't know.
And what's it like performing? Because presumably they're just quite depressed, people.
I love it. Because they're all so free and happy.
Do you mean drunk? Yeah. They went in Dennis Hopper state of mind. Now, you've got a new album, which I have here.
Oh.
And there's quite personal songs on here.
Yeah.
Now, what's the one? I shouldn't make me laugh because it obviously it's to do with heartache.
Oh.
But
you laugh.
Well, just because I like the name of it. Where is it? Maybe it's not on this album. What's the one about? I wish I'd never met you.
Oh, that one didn't go on the album.
Oh.
That one was real personal.
Yeah, because you don't need to go into the story. But I liked it. What was it called?
I liked that one. I wish I never met you. Yes.
About your ex-boyfriend?
Yes.
I like that, just as a title. I wish I'd never met you.
Yes.
I wonder where this song's going. Yeah.
It was a very, a calm fuck you, if you like. It was the calmest way I could do it. I wanted to do it quiet, but it's like nobody gets to hear it because there was like a writing issue and I felt like somebody put a bad... I'm all about energy. I wanted my album to be a good energy.
A happy
through.
Place.
And it wasn't very nice energy, so I took it off. But it does sound nice. I sing it in my show. So.
And very quickly, this is just reading the thing. There was a thing about you were defending Tom Cruise somewhere.
Yeah, probably.
There would be no Tom Cruise jokes in the show. But it seems to, it's weird. British people go to Hollywood and then they just become friends with, like, so Tom Cruise just invites you around to his house.
Just really nice, you know.
But he just invites you around to his house.
Yeah, he's funny. He just liked my music a lot, so he was like,
"Well, I did. I bought your CD. Which I didn't mean? Invite you around to my house. I've got a piano. Could you come over?"
He's just a sweet, kind of different, but it's very sweet.
You met him? She's got him there, yes. Very sweet, but different.
He is really nice.
Very good. And you're doing the Diana concert next weekend?
Or
Yes.
Yes.
And, is it true that you're introducing Joss Stone?
I believe so,
yes. I didn't know that. Thank you.
Yeah. Well, I believe so. You know, I heard that today, you know, whether, you know. Things but I know I'm doing the concert.
Well, thank
concert.
You very much if you do.
Yeah.
It'll be lovely.
I'd probably turn up as well, you know.
Yeah, why not?
Just for a laugh.
We'll all introduce you.
All right, wicked.
And is it true, the thing in Heat, about Prince William ringing you?
No.
No.
Or is it?
I spoke to him one time. One time. And now we're, like, having intimate conversation. I've had so many boyfriends this year in all the papers, and I haven't had one. I'm like, I wish my life was that interesting. It's very funny.
You haven't had one?
No, well, I haven't been dating anyone for, like, 2 years.
She's going to write a song about him. I mean...
Now, you love dogs, I know.
I do.
Because you've got two dogs?
Yeah.
What are they called?
Missy Elliot is a Rottweiler, and she's pregnant. I just found out yesterday. Don't do that. She's left.
No.
So she's got a boyfriend.
She has a boyfriend. And then there's Dusty Springfield. She's a little teacup poodle. She's gorgeous.
Oh.
I love them so much.
I've got a Larissa dog, and I've actually started to call her Pissy Elliot.
Oh.
Yes. Yeah. No, she gets excited, and then, oh, I'm so excited I could... Oh, I have.
Oh. Is she puppy?
No.
Oh.
No, she's just Pissy Elliot. But, now, there's a little dog news for you.
Okay.
Because the world's ugliest dog was crowned this week. I don't know if you saw it. It was quite a big news story in America. Are you ready for the picture of the world's ugliest dog? You ready? Deep breath. Here we go. Oh, no, sorry. Sorry, that's clearly the wrong picture. Here we go. Whoa! Now, it's called...
Look, bless his little heart.
I know. It's called...
Oh!
He's called...
Is there something wrong with him?
Yes. Now, what he is a cross between a Chinese crested and a Chihuahua. Mm. And a food blender. Well, here's one of the runners-up.
Oh, that's cute, though. No,
but apparently, a lot of these dogs, I think, I don't know what it is, I think the tongue is too big for their mouths or something.
Yeah.
So the tongue is out the whole time. Now,
the tongue is just trying to escape from them.
Yeah, he just want to be in there. Here it is with its owner. Ooh, kiss that. Karen Quigley told the papers, "I can't decide whether Elwood is cute or ugly." Let's have a look again. I'd go with ugly. But no, we can't ask her because she's on the line now from New Jersey. Hello, Karen.
Hello, how are you?
I'm ever so well. How's Elwood?
Oh, he's terrific.
Now, he's two, is he?
Yes, he is. He's two.
And was he a cute puppy?
He was a cute puppy. I thought he was cute from the moment I saw him. He was totally white when we found him.
Now that's love.
Aww.
And as he got older, he got darker and got all the little spots on him.
Yeah, but you did enter him into a world's ugliest dog competition.
Well, that was truly at the insistence of my friend. She just encouraged me to do that, and we thought it would be a lot of fun. And Elwood took second place last year. He didn't win, so he had to go back this year to take the crown.
And send him back.
Yeah, because Joss Stone's here. She was just saying, because backstage, is it like kind of ugly cruffs? Is it like, are you backstage kind of hitting your dog in the face with a stick or something? How do you prepare him for the ugliest dog competition?
You just bring him and you just let him be natural. This is all natural beauty to him.
And can his tongue not fit in his mouth?
His tongue cannot go in his mouth. It's not that it's too big. I did hear a lot of people say that. He just doesn't have any teeth on the left side of his mouth to keep it in, so it falls out all the time.
Getting some falsies or something.
I know. Surely in America there's some sort of veterinarian dentist.
Somewhere in LA there will be something.
There'll be a dog plastic surgeon restructuring it. And are you at all worried about people say, you know, that owners start to resemble their pets?
Okay, there. I think we're fine.
Well, thank you very much for sharing your experience. What did you win, by the way?
Elwood won $1,600 and a 4-foot trophy and a blue ribbon.
What? I'm not being rude, but what the fuck is he going to do with a 4-foot trophy?
If the prize was some teeth, it might have been worthwhile.
All right, very nice to talk to you, Karen.
Thank you very much.
Ciao. Listen. We're going to have a song for you now.
Yeah.
Yes, we are. But just time to welcome back our bronze statue man. Alex is here. I think he's here. There he is. Well done, you. It's impressive.
Yeah.
It does look... That is a false. It's not you.
Oh, it's false, yeah.
Yes, it is false. Well, it's well done to you. Commemorate your installation on the South Bank. We've created this collector's T-shirt. There it is, of you. I went to London and all I saw was this lousy statue. That's you, sir. Thank you very much, Alex. Off you go. Have a shower. All right, take care. Goodbye. Blessed. Please start my guest. Dennis Hopper, Ardal O'Hanlon, and Joss Stone. You want to go over there and sing? There we go. We're about to do our Cooldown, which you can see as a video podcast now on the website or watch the repeat this Sunday night. Now to play us out with her new single, Tell Me What We're Gonna Do Now, it is Joss Stone. Yeah. I'll see you next week. Good night, everybody. Bye-bye.
Your mind up. I just wanna take my time with you. If that's all right,
it's all right, it's all right.
Forgive me if I get too shy, but maybe you're the reason why I love. I'm feeling butterfly. Something by the look in your eyes. Oh, it just makes me feel. When my mind's
off
your mind,
sure.
You're the dream when I'm sleeping. Hey, I'm
for you.
Yeah, I
adore.
You're everything that I need. And I
love
you. Love me. Oh, if I'm made for you, then you're made for me.
It's too good to be.
So tell me what we're gonna do now. Would you tell me what we're gonna do now? How my world keeps spinning. Sometimes you can be so silly. Know just how to make me laugh. Ooh. And your skin is so lovely. You move me when you touch me. I know that you got my back. Ooh. It feels so safe when you hold me. I'm
would you tell me what we're gonna do now? Tell me what we're gonna do now.
The singing in the bare feet.
Yeah, I'm such a wuss, man. I get nervous and I fall, so I can't wear shoes. People want me to say, you know, I want to be close to the earth.
But it was just you fall over.
I feel the ground. No, I just fall over everything. I'm so.
But have you sung in shoes ever?
I did it once.
And not a happy.
I did
thing.
It once for James Brown, and that's the only man I'll ever do it for, and I can't do that again. So.
Did he insist on you wearing shoes?
No, he didn't. But Betty Wright called me because basically the president was there.
Okay.
Georgie Porgy Pudding and Pie.
Yeah.
He was there, so my mum wanted me to wear shoes. And I said, he's not my president. No, thank you very much. So then Betty Wright called me and said, oh, no, but it's James Brown. You can't disrespect James Brown. I was like, OK.
So you wore shoes?
I wore shoes. And guess what? I stood on my own foot and it started to bleed. No joke.
But you did very well in those shoes earlier.
Yeah, but this was like 5 years ago.
Yeah, but singing, no.
Yeah, no, I get too scared. I'm like...
And how's band? Or band all very well?
No,
we were good. But... Were you all in Glastonbury?
Yeah.
Yep. Did she leave you in the mud as well? No.
They went.
Yeah, was it as bad as everyone said?
Yes.
Yes, it was. It was awful. Well, listen, this is our cool down bit where basically this is the bit that goes on the podcast or on the Sunday repeat.
Lovely.
So this week what we're doing is we're doing a picture drawing guessing game, Pictionary. Based on Dennis Hopper's films. So if you come here,
okay.
Dennis, Ardal, do you mind if you just come over here? So if you sit on those stools, gentlemen, basically, people are going to come down, they're going to draw a picture, and you're going to have to guess which of your films it is. Okay, so who's first to do it? Oh, man right there, come down, quick. So basically this is Pictionary, but all the things we're guessing are Dennis's films.
All right.
Okay, so here you go, sir. There's markers there. Okay, wait.
Jesus.
Okay.
It's very important.
That's the next
right
film you're doing.
Okay.
Okay, don't say the word and don't write the word. Your time starts now. What's your name, by the way?
Ian.
Ian, go, Ian. Okay. Go. Okay. If audience guess, you could help the guests.
Speed.
Yes, you're right. Well done, Ian. Very good.
Could I just point out?
Yes.
That was also an episode of Father Ted.
Speed was
yes, it was, yes.
With the milk flows.
That's right.
Oh, yes. Oh, if you've never seen it, it is a brilliant homage to Speed.
It's hilarious.
Where, what is it, the milk float can't
go
under.
Above 4 miles an hour.
Oh, above 4 miles an hour.
There's a bomb underneath.
Very funny. Thank you, Ian. Thank go you. Away. Next, who's next? Lady up there, come on down. Okay, very good. Whoa, look at them. Okay. Okay, stairs are your friend. Okay, let's get you a clean piece of paper. What's your name, by the way?
Emily.
All right, Emily. Here's your challenge. Draw that. Okay, don't spit on it. Okay. Okay, that's not helping, is this? Anyone guess? Actually, in fairness, it is Apocalypse Now, but you're just guessing Dennis Hopper films. That is not helping. No.
That'd be a big boom.
That's a big boom.
Bomb.
Emily, that's shit. Go on, back. All right, next. Oh, you're right there. Come up here.
Wait till Francis sees that, huh?
I know, really.
You'll know where he went wrong.
Hey, what's your name?
Sarah.
All right, Sarah. Quite a difficult one. Okay, good luck.
Please.
Yeah, that will help. Buzz in if you know.
Oh, sorry.
Yes, Miss Stone?
Blue Velvet.
Yeah, right, it's Blue Velvet. That was all
thank
the
cute.
Yeah, that was good. One other person? Oh, you jump over there. Go on. Health and safety be damned. Hooray. Well done. What's your name, sir?
Jamie.
Jamie. Jamie's keen. Okay. Oh, you've got quite a... That, you'll be able to do that, surely. Oh, yeah, Jamie. By the way, you've got something stuck in your hair. Yeah, oh, come on, you know what this is. Yes, yes.
It's Easy Rider, of course.
It's Easy Rider. I like the fight. Yeah. Thank you very much. Sit you down. Okay, one more. Oh, yes, go on, you. Okay, quick, come on. Hurry, hurry, hurry. What's your name?
David.
David, all right. That's your movie right there. Okay. Very good. Yes?
It's Blue Velvet again.
No, it's...
Waterworld.
Yes! Well done, you. All right. Oh, this is... Oh, we'll finish on this one because it's really hard. Okay. Is anyone very good at Pictionary? I mean, picture drawing, guessing-based game? Is Emily's friend better than Emily? Well, in fairness, she could only be better than Emily. What? Do you want to have a go? Go on, then. Yeah, come on down. Here you go. Here you go. Here you go. This is very difficult. Okay, what's Emily's name, Emily's friend?
Alyssa.
Alyssa? Alyssa. Very good. Okay. Oh, sorry, I haven't turned the page. I have cares on it. Okay. You didn't need them. Okay, that's the film.
Oh, shit.
So what's that? What is that?
Burning hand.
It's a hand.
With nails.
With nails.
Burning.
It's not burning. It's the opposite of burning. Emily's better at doing... you're much better at this side of it. Yeah, I'll buzz that for Emily. Go on, last line, Emily. Yes, it is cool hand loom. Well done. Now, Dennis, did you seriously not know any of those?
Not really, yeah. I must have been in some sort of stupor.
Old titles.
Oh, yeah.
Listen, that's the end of our cooldown. Thank you very much, audience. And one more time for our lovely guests, Ardal, Dennis.